Hello there, my name is Erwin. Welcome back to my Technic workshop. Let's first address the angry red elephant in the room. I know it's not red, but it looks angry. I think that everyone has seen the many videos about COPPA by now. I'm not going to talk about it in great detail, because other people have done an excellent job explaining it. And there really isn't that much more information out there. Not anything factual anyway. More rumors and people panicking. And I don't think that is necessary. Not right now. I just started my channel. I didn't know about COPPA. Or the fine that YouTube got. The $170 million fine, I think. I didn't know about it. I started my channel to share my Lego hobby. And I'm still planning on doing that. And I've marked my channel as not for kids. I know my channel is about Lego. Lego is a toy for kids and adults. I know it's appealing for them, but they were never my intended audience. It's fine that they watch, but I didn't make it for them. Currently, none of my three videos are marked as for kids. I don't expect them to be, but you never know. And if they are, I will appeal this. And then we will see what Google says. But until we get a bit more factual information and we really know what we can and cannot do, I'll be just really careful, but I'm going to continue. So expect more videos from me. So now let's talk about more happy things. This week I made this labyrinth. It's a game where you need to get a ball from the top left corner to the bottom right corner. You usually find them in wood and a little bit smaller, but I made this one too large. In the labyrinth there are multiple dead ends and holes that your ball can drop in, or your marble, or whatever you want to use. And when this happens, you lost the game. The labyrinth consists out of an outer box, a mailbox and an inner box, and they can tilt like I'm showing in the video right now. So your ball can roll to the left, the right, the front and the back. And you can navigate the maze that way. As I said, I made this labyrinth too large. Especially the middle box is bending because of the weight of the inner box. It's really heavy. That's why it is not really working. You can do it manually, but I wanted to make it automated. Like a great ball contraption, I wanted to use actuators to move the boxes, but I didn't get it to work, and I ran out of technical pins, so I couldn't build more components. I ordered the pins on Bricklink now, so my next project I won't run out. But in the end, it was a fun project to make, and even from things that don't work, you will learn. So, better luck next time. This is one of the components for the maze I was working on. I built everything in components and I combined them. And that will make the final product. In this case I wanted to make an actuator that goes up and down without reversing the motor every time. I'm doing that using an arm that's connected to a gear that slowly rotates, pushing and pulling an arm with the gear racks on it, on the bottom of it. I will show you in the video. That rotates a gear again that makes the actuator go up and down, and that was the whole idea, but friction is way too much and the movement isn't smooth enough. So this is version 1, it's a failure, up to the next version. If you have any ideas, let me know. This is another component I made for the maze project. It is basically a two-channel random generator, because I wanted to move the inside and the middle box independent of each other in a random way. I tried doing this by using the pins you see on the top, the red and the blue pins. Sorry, the red and the black pins. I'm not colorblind. The red and the black pins, they have a random length when the box rotates. I wanted to use the difference in length to raise a lever and convert that motion again in rotation. of access. I have no idea how yet, but that was my idea. And it actually works pretty well. So maybe you will see this in another project. I will open up the drum for you so you can see what kind of magic happens inside. It's actually really easy. The drum is filled with small 2x2 Lego blocks. And these blocks rotate and mix and block the pins who are in the inside as well. And that makes it have a random length. As I said, it works, but it has one disadvantage. And that is that it makes a lot of noise. But when you rotate it very slowly, it's doable, I think. Something completely different what I did this week was making this photo for Instagram. It resembles lunch atop a rooftop in New York, 1932, I think. I made a beam from red lift arms and put three minifigures on it, technical minifigures, and used my monitor for the background. The cityscape is a photo from Unsplash. And I think it turned out really well. If you haven't joined my Instagram yet, please do so. And finally, I want to share this device with you. I found it on YouTube. It's made by Tiango T5 Lego. I will put this link in the description. He made this two-way to one-way mechanism, as he called it. And it is really nice and compact, and it will always rotate counterclockwise, even when you rotate the input counterclockwise or clockwise. It's based on two ratchets connected to each other. I will show you and open it, but you should watch his original video. This was it for today. See you in the next video.